Dear viewer, you are welcome to this exposition on this platform. Let us pray. Father, we commit this moment into your hand, and we want to give admonition by your spirit. I pray that I receive guidance in these things, so that through me the hearer will benefit. And by your mercy, even in little things, we will see your finger and we will glorify thee. Thank you, Lord. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. This is admonition number two. And I'm going to speak on this topic, consider little things. And this number two, I think is going to run, this consider little things may run into admonition 2A, 2B, 2C, before we go into admonition number three. Because this 2A, 2B, 2C, they are all concentrated on consider little things. The message may be brief. It's not the time factor that matters here. But we want to segment them in such a way that when you take time, even if it is a few minutes, to listen to this message, by the mercies of God, you benefit something. Now, I want us to consider little things in our lives. Because little things are often offshoots of greater things. And when you fail to consider the little things, you also fail to harness the greater things arising from those little things that will come into manifestation. When we say through little things, great things come into manifestation, it doesn't mean that all little things give birth to great things that are good. Some little things can give birth to great things that are also bad. That is why consideration is important by you and I. So that you will know that in this little thing I'm involved, from it will rise a bigger evil. Then you'll be set free before such evils will come into manifestation. You will also know if the little thing will give birth to something good and big, then you don't neglect that little thing. Something I have discovered in the journey of life, that big things, good things, big good things can come out from small things. If you read the Bible book of Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 1, it says, dead flies cause the ointment of the apothecary to send forth a stinging savour. So doth a little folly him that is in reputation for wisdom and honor. See? That is, it is said that dead flies can cause, even where you have an ointment, dead flies can cause certain kind of ointment not to send out forth the aroma, the good aroma of the ointment, but to contaminate it and send forth stinking savour, that is offensive odor. That a dead fly is something insignificant, dead fly, but look at what it is said that it can cause. So in the same way, a little foolishness can dishonor the reputation of a wise man. So don't you see that as you go on in life, as we go on in life, we have to be very, very careful about so many things, even the little things, the so-called little things. Because sometimes great success may be kept for you. I'm not going to spend time in this message. Admonition 2A. Consider little things. That way I am. Admonition 2A. Consider little things. Now, listen, my dear viewer. Something great in your life can come out from little things. Now, the email you sent forth, or the email you failed to send forth, the action of sending that email is a little action. It's a little action. But in that email may lie great things for you. That is where the universal law of probabilities come into play. The thought of sending the email, the thought of not sending the email. In those little, that little effort, maybe greater sources awaits you upon sending that email. And by your refusing to send that email, you have closed the door of that particular success. You have closed the door of that particular good thing. That when we talk about consider, it also means we should not be lazy. You see? The call that you want to make, you want to call somebody, a thought comes to you, say, call that person. Another call says, don't call. That action of trying to make that call is a little action, but inside it may lie the success, greater success of your life. So if your success lies in that call, that little effort of making that call, and you fail to make that call, you have set aside that success. Now if that call is also designed to bring big problem to you, you're refusing to make it, you have also overcome something. So we have to be in a constant mood of consideration of things. But I think that our consideration should not be only on big things. That is why I say consider little things. The greetings, you see somebody said, I don't want to greet this person. I don't want to greet this person. And your reason is baseless. You don't know whether greeting that person, inside greeting that person, lies greater success for your life. Because you may greet today, greet tomorrow. Even when you feel that you're offended, you keep on, you humble yourself, practice humility, and greet. Maybe, for instance, you may be even a woman, and somebody comes to meet that person you are greeting. And to ask, who is this woman? Let us find out. By the time, because of that your greeting, the person bear good witness of you. And that person that is making that question may be making inquiry for himself or for somebody greater than him. Before you put one on one together, two and two together, before you know, in the next 1 year, 2 years, that particular greeting there will become the impetus for you to be married. Some of you that believe that you must marry a worthy man, that is a good desire for you to marry such a worthy man. So, but your refusal to greet that, to send for that greeting, or you are proud, you are very arrogant, you know, you may close the door. Unknown to you that you have closed the door. Many of us, we close the door of good things against ourselves in so many ways, but we don't know that the door is closed. You see? Now, if you read the book of Proverbs chapter 30, you see example given about little creatures there. Proverbs 30 from verse 24 to 28 says, there be four things which are little upon the earth, but they are exceeding wise. The ants are a people not strong, yet they prepare their meat in the summer. The cornies are but a feeble folk, yet make their houses in the rocks. The locusts have no king, yet go they forth, all of them by bands. The spider taketh hold with her hands and is in king's palaces. That is Proverbs chapter 30, from verse 24 to 28. You see the activities of these little things. How they achieve, like they said, there be four things which are little upon the earth, but they are exceeding wise. In their littleness lies great wisdom. And look at the things accomplished by them in that their littleness. Say the ants are a people not strong, yet they prepare their meat in the summer. They are a people, creatures not strong, but they prepare their meat in the summer by collective effort, by utilizing all abilities given to them, by not being slothful, by cooperative endeavor. Man must learn from that. Because I went to a family that lost their beloved one, and they invited me to talk to them, and I gathered all of them together. And I told them, I said, look, I asked one of them to go and bring broom. You know, over here, we have brooms, you know, just sweeping, gather them. Then you know what I mean by broom. Brooms. So by the time they gather the brooms, and I asked them, I said, now, a bunch of broom, break it. I gave it to the first one, break, cannot break. You can't break a bunch of broom. That when you got a broom gathered and tied, you break it. You can't break it. Then I brought out one stick of each of the broom. I said, okay, come. This is just a stick of the broom. Break it. Bam, breaks it. This one, break it. Bam, breaks it. This one, breaks it. We are told to love our enemies, but the enemies are there. And the enemy will do the work of enemy. You see? So what I am saying is that we have to take example of these ants mentioned here. Now look at them, they are a little but look at what they prepare their food in summer by collective effort. In your families, don't say, oh, my people are unbelievers, they are demons. If they are demons, through your prayers, through collective effort, continue, be steadfast, love them, walk in light with them. Light changes, transforms darkness, you know. But by true cooperation, a family is built upon a foundation of victory. But when this one goes the other way, the other one goes, that is all of them, they are scattered. Then it's easier for the enemies to come in and have dominion. You see, then he also mentioned that the cornies are but a feeble folk, yet make they their houses in the rocks. You see, you know, the cornies, you know, the sort of just creatures, you see them, especially like in, it's like European rats or something. Now, you see, they make their houses in the rocks, but yet they are feeble people. You see, by collective effort, by wisdom, by putting little things into consideration, great things are achieved. He said, the locusts have no king, yet go they forth, all of them, by bands. They have no king, but they go in one accord, because they have one mind. Because they have, it's like saying that they have love. Because where love is, their love is the king there. He also said that the spider taketh hold with her hands, and is in king's palaces. You see, the spider, you know, by taking hold of her own hand in wisdom, is found in king's palaces. By so doing, he breaks the protocol, and is there in his farm. So what lessons we learn here is that through little things, great things can be achieved. And the fasting you are told to fast, which you did or which you abandoned inside them, inside any of these such probabilities, lies to meditate. Maybe if you do the fasting, it will activate a whole lot of things for you. You abandoning the fasting also can bring about certain type of failure in some places. So, like I said, I don't intend to take much time in each of this segment now. I'll be back shortly to continue this consider little things to be. Let the Almighty Father bless you and help you so that help all of us so that by His mercy we will consider little things and will not allow our eye in big things to make us not to see the good and big things that little things will bring forth by the Spirit of the Lord. May the Father bless the view of this message in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. We will consider little things and will not allow our eye in big things to make us not to see the good and big things that little things will bring forth by the Spirit of the Lord. May the Father bless the view of this message in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.